Space Coconut.
Okay, today we're going to talk about the Discordance nerf and why this nerf is the exact reason why perk tiers should be removed. Before I get into this one, be sure to sub if you're new and hit the bell if you don't want to miss any videos in the future. I'm not a normal DBD content creator, so if you ever feel like my videos are worth sharing, please do so more people can get into the conversation. The more people we have talking about the issues in the game we enjoy, the more likely we might have a positive influence in making Dead by Daylight a more enjoyable experience for everyone. If you ever want to discuss anything you see in my videos, come by Twitch where I'm live every Saturday, with some random streams sprinkled in during the week. Join the Discord if you want to talk with other coconuts about anything you feel like, and maybe find out when those random streams will be during the week. Links to everything are in the description. So, the original Discordance said, anytime two or more survivors are working on the same generator, that generator's aura is highlighted in yellow for 8, 10, and 12 seconds. The new Discordance now has a limited range of 32, 64, and 96 meters. It triggers one loud noise notification for a generator when it's first touched by another survivor. The aura will fade away 8 seconds after the survivors leave the generator. Now, the change to Discordance is really negligible. Many people would keep it at tier 1 so they had a better indication of when a survivor left a generator, and there was even a debate going on about whether tier 1 or tier 3 was better. So because Discordance was such an impactful perk, and so many people were using it in all of their builds, and as many other people were making forum posts about it, about how overpowered it was, and how a single Discordance notification could change the course of the match, the devs clearly found that it was such a huge issue that they needed to reduce its effectiveness with a very well-planned and thought-out change to the perk. I have no idea why the devs change things that no one really cares about, and in the case of Discordance, it's really a non-issue. Yes, technically they nerfed it by slapping a range on it, but I want you to shift your focus for a second. Why did they need to add a range to it? If the range wasn't added, everyone would have gotten Discordance at tier 1 with one noise notification when a second survivor started working on the generator. If we got that, what would the different tiers be? The devs needed to add the range requirement because they needed a reason to give the perk tiers. And as we all know, the primary reason for the massive grind we currently suffer through is due to the number of perk tiers we have to obtain. As of this writing, a single survivor has to grind through 246 perk tiers, and a killer needs to grind through 222 perk tiers to have all the perks at tier 3. This grind is unnecessary, and the Discordance change highlights the fact that the grind is deliberate. Now, I know that many people are going to say that the game needs the grind so people feel like they're working towards something. Okay, you're right, but what if they removed perk tiers? Gave them all to the players outright so they could play with any build when they first started playing, and then awarded iridescent shards for completing the blood webs? Huh? Cosmetics, even if they're just recolors, would go a long way to helping players feel like they're working towards something. Of course, this would be consumer friendly, and their masters from NetEase can't have that. I used to play grindy MMOs. I built my first PC so I could play Final Fantasy XI, and back in the day it took a very long time to get to the hub city of Juno and get your air pass to be able to travel between the major cities. I'm no stranger to grind, but there should be value and achievement tied to that grind. Having perks that are borderline requirements for some killers, locked behind an RNG grind, makes the situation a mandatory grind in order to play the game with the perks that you want. The range requirement on Discordance covers the map. If you're patrolling, you're probably within range of a generator on any map. So it's basically like it doesn't have a range anyway. But they can't set a precedent of a perk having only one tier, can they? You can be mad about the Discordance change if you want, but it might be a better use of your time if you're upset that they still haven't changed Decisive Strike, or taken care of whatever killer thing you survivor turds don't like. On the topic of the grind, it's Tuesday night, and the new Blight skins look great. As usual, the design team does an amazing job, but it pisses me off that the Legion's multi-body horror skin looks so much better than the Hag's skin did for the Archive. I was wildly disappointed. It's like they put hers together as an afterthought and then realized they could do the same for the Legion and have the skin actually make sense because there were multiple people involved in the single killer. So I'm still sticking with the red dress until something better comes along. However, I'm worried that as I write this, that I'm actually right about the event and we won't be able to earn Blight cosmetics. Not being able to buy the Ghost's Blight cosmetic makes complete sense. And it's great that a licensed killer has a Blight costume, but Halloween is Dead by Daylight's flagship holiday. I'd argue that Halloween should be an even bigger event than their yearly ego trip called the Anniversary. This is a game in the horror genre. Why isn't something huge planned for Halloween?
But this was straight from hell. Go check that out.
Halloween events have been going on all month for many other games, and yet here we are with a 2-week period of time filled with a paid grind fest. And don't you just love those people that say, you should be glad they did anything at all? These are the people that play those sandbagging survivors and face camping killers that you hate to go against. Yeah, they're horrible people who think that you should be thankful that the devs let you pay them money for things that used to be free. Yes, the original Blight event had problems, but the devs tried to do something new. Unfortunately, instead of learning from their many mistakes they've made over the past 4.5 years, they make new mistakes that baffle the community as a whole. I mean, how hard is it to plug in a PlayStation and test the changes for this patch? There have been framerate issues for months, and instead of taking care of that, they need to make sure that their paid Halloween event goes live regardless of whether anything else in the game actually works the way it's supposed to. If the shop was giving away Oryx cells or cosmetics for free, you bet your ass that they'd be fixed the very next day. As you're watching this, I'm probably at work, and the event should have started. I really hope I'm wrong about this. I really do. Prove me wrong, devs. Please. Follow me on Twitter and let me know how it turns out. I'll be watching that while I'm at work. Like the video if you like the video, and dislike the video if you want tricks instead of treats. Until next time, I'll see you on the grind. Ah!